outside the white line.
Yes, we were following the rules.
We were following the rules, and a ball comes over our direction, but we can't see it. Somebody yells heads up, and instinctively you turn around and you snare it one-handed with your off left hand. So now we're really ready for football.
No gloves either.
No gloves.
No gloves. Not like what the guys are wearing playing the game now. But wasn't that a whole lot better than that time we were down there? And I got the coffee spilled on me when I got nailed by the punt returner.
That happened to the Vikings, right?
Yeah, it's a much better job of being heads up this time. Thank you for the notice.
Let's go, let's go. Fight Kittle, let's go.
Down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. 14 yards there on the first play from scrimmage.
His position, and he's listed as a tight end, but he certainly doesn't run like one, and that's what we're seeing more and more coming into the league. Those guys who can run, make plays after the catch, and gain that additional yardage.
And using that speed there to turn it into a pretty nice little gain.
But we just saw a great example of what we talked about with his coach prior to the game. He's definitely one of the better linebackers at reading a play and flowing to make the stop before it turns into something big.
Throwing on second and eight, Brady. He's got his all-pro receiver, Michael Thomas. And he'll take this to the other side of midfield before going out of bounds. It's a first down on a gain of 10. So into Pat's territory now. Here's first and 10 at the 46. Brady down to throw. This one into the hands of Kittle, the tight end. A gain of 6 there on first.
Brady, they didn't get everything they wanted out of that play, but the tight end did. Great job of him holding on after absorbing that big hit. Whenever we talk about the best strong safeties, one word constantly comes up, and that's instinct. Being able to diagnose run or pass and make the appropriate moves.
He crashed down hard there. He was ready for that running play.
Let's go, let's go, let's go.
But not before they're inside the 25. A nice carry there of 15 yards. Had a chance to maybe limit them to 3 if they could have gotten that stop there, but a new set of downs.
And with a new set of downs, you got to take the mentality of the whole thing. Right, everyone's looking at the offense and saying,
that's bad. He had them clouds.
Just, okay, new set of downs gives us another chance to make a play ourselves and maybe change things up.
And Brady's throw there incomplete. From the 24, they'll go again on second and 10.
Come on.
And he'll get a couple here down to the 22. A minimal gain there on the 8th play of the drive.
One thing to keep in mind, partner, especially in the second half, when you've got a running back of this size, of these dimensions, I can just tell you, attrition does set in for a defense because you're excited about hitting him in the first half. Maybe not so much in the second half, and some of these shorter gains turn into bigger runs later.
Let's go. Let's go, Zeke.
And he'll finally be taken down at the 2-yard line. They're able to convert on third down, and that sets up a first and goal. Quite the opening drive march there.
Let's go. Let's go. Let's go.
Practice prior to the game, doesn't it? You know, because on that last big practice beforehand, you go through your offensive script, you go through your play calling, you go through all the stuff and establish things, and it looks like it's going like clockwork right now for them.
Come on, you gotta give me that.
And just a short gain that time as they're able to get him down. Only a yard on the pickup there. Second and goal. Good first step there defensively, but they're still knocking on the doorstep, so maybe another run here?
I think so. One of my favorite coaches just say something.
And he is in the end zone for a touchdown.
Let's go,
Ezekiel
let's go.
Elliott taking it in. And this offense takes the ball down the field and scores on their opening drive. Extra point by Fairbairn, up and good. And that makes the score 7-0. Here's Martin now following the score as he'll send
this
one.
Let's go, let's go, let's
go. Fielded about a yard deep. And he'll take it up past the 25 to the 26-yard line.
going to play offset tight end. I'm picking off.
That'll be knocked away. It's incomplete. Jalen Ramsey right there in coverage to knock it away.
It's always a battle. Who's going to win on first down? The offense or the defense? Let's face it. If you've got the ball, 4 yards or more on first down is what you're aiming for. They tried to throw for it there. Nice effort to knock down with a way and bring up second down.
They throw again on second down. This one's complete. 4 yards on the completion, and it sets up a third down. Now, Charles, what's the mindset here offensively? You gave up the touchdown pretty quickly. Would it have changed if you had gotten a stop and it would be 0-0 right now or no?
I wouldn't think so. I think in most cases, just down a touchdown, you know, I mean, we're just getting started here. It should be a long way to go. You think to yourself,
lay him down. Lay him down.
Down he goes. Luck is sacked. The sack that time by Michael Strahan. Great job defensively. I think he was trying to go through his progressions, find someone to get rid of the football. Before he knew it, he was on his back.
So that just brings us right back to what you said in the beginning. A great job defensively. Nowhere to go with the football. That led to the sack.
And boy, down a touchdown already, but they're going to line up to go for it on their side of the field. They're going to go. It's locked. It's complete to Graham. They're able to keep the drive alive. 7 yards that time, and the decision to go for it proves to be a good one.
Well, peel back the curtain, partner. We've got a pretty good look into how they plan to play this game. Aggressive seems to be the word. Going for it on fourth down in that situation.
Yeah, opening drive. Now, we know this coaching staff, they have traits of aggression in their history.
Lay down!
Pressure, and he'll go down. They'll sack him on what ought to be the final play of this first quarter. Michael Strahan, able to get in there for his second sack of the afternoon. Coming up now on a second and 15 following
Let's go,
sack.
Let's go.
Throwing his
Oh, we have to run. We have to run.
DeMarcus Lawrence with a sack.
I'm starting to feel for that quarterback back there. I mean, you know me. Normally, don't have a lot of empathy for the QB, right? In this case, he's been on constant duress this entire game. I don't know how he's surviving back there.
And to think, there's still a long way to go in this football game. Looking left side, and he's got a man. That's Grant. They do get 10 back, but still a ways to go on fourth.
That's certainly playing down in distance very well by the defense, isn't it? Take whatever you want underneath, by all means.
No move to get the offense off the field here. They've converted once on this drive. On fourth, they'll go again and try it once more. They are going for it. It's locked. And he fires one that's intercepted. Picked off by Jalen Ramsey.
And Brandon, this is a real nice job defensively, getting inside a quarterback's head and figuring out, okay, where is he going with the football? Because you can make an educated guess defensively, not all the
Let's
time,
go.
But sometimes. And when you're right, you've got a decent chance of coming away with the football.
So after the INT, it's Brady.
It's cover four.
End zone, but it's incomplete.
Brandon, it looked like he had his hands on it for a moment, but let's face it, that was going to be a tough catch all the way because of the presence of the defense right there as he was trying to haul it in.
Simplify everything.
Force the incompletion. Brady's incompletion on first down leads to a second and 10. To throw again, Brady.
Come on, bro.
And they're going to get him. He's sacked back. 28, the number
okay. He's boxing with this cover four.
Well, it was second long, now it's
I had to get this field goal a little bit closer because I don't know what my kicker's going
to
do.
Exactly the way they want to, but you're exactly right. Definitely going the wrong direction for the offensive guys.
And he's not going to get anywhere close to the marker as they'll stop him well short of the yellow line.
But it appeared to be a run blitz. He just darted in once he saw the run develop. That appeared to be a case of see ball, get ball.
They got the interception, but very little movement after, and that forces him to settle for three. And it does feel like settling when that happens, doesn't it?
It certainly does, but we got to give a lot of credit where it's due, and that's to the defense because they ran onto the field. It's what we call sudden change, right? Interception, you got to go put out the fire.
I got something for him next time.
Holding them to a field goal.
He got to change his offense. He can't run the same thing.
Comes the New England offense to see what they can do this time. Nothing for them yet from an offensive standpoint. Down 10 zip as they come up first and 10. Trying to shake off the interception. He'll look to throw. And this is Ertz with it, right side. And from the 25, they work this to the 29, a gain of 4. That throw good for 4. It's second down. They don't need
Let's
to run
go.
Another
Let's
play
go. Let's
here before the 2 minute warning.
Throw that. Throw the post.
Looking to throw again on second down.
Give me that.
Incomplete.
Give me that.
This defense has been very disruptive early on as they force another one to go awry.
Seems to be the front and the back end. Pass rush, they've been able to get home, and they're taking the ball away in coverage as well.
I love how you put it together. The front and back working in sync.
Throw it.
Only way to play
throw it.
Defense.
Throw it. That's good stuff. He mixed it up. That's good stuff. He mixed it up.
First half on EA Sports. Coming up at halftime in a little less than 2 minutes.
I think this is it. I think this is it.
Coachman is standing by. He'll have highlights and analysis of this first half. On first down, it's Love. Caught by the tight end.
Lay him down. Lay him down.
A good pickup there. 8 yards on the first down completion.
And there's a completion to the tight end. And look at the size of these players nowadays. At that spot, 6'4", 6'5", and up. A lot of guys used to be basketball players, somehow came back to football. That's really good for the game of football. You get better athleticism, great hand-eye coordination. Guys who know how to control their bodies when they run their routes.
A gain of 5, good enough for the first down.
This has to go down as one of the simpler routes in the playbook, but oh so effective. Nice completion there. Keeps the sticks moving.
Luck on first down. Gonna throw right side here. Complete. The catch and run. Good for 24 yards.
That looked like a pretty good route combination there because you've got to find a way to clear the guy running the drag. When you
Let's see what you're going to do.
Some space. On first down, Luck.
Oh my God, I just powered you up.
There, almost intercepted. Instead, second down.
Well, nearly another interception there. That would have been two drives in a row with a pick. He's got to start taking care of the ball way better than what we're seeing.
Interestingly, that throw was probably worse than the one he threw the interception on last drive, but fell incomplete.
I manned you up. I have a deep safety. Come on.
As far as I'm concerned, Andrew Luck can do it all. I mean, he's an underrated.
My connection. Come on, bro.
Strong and stout. But let's face it, the money that comes from his arm
and smart valedictorian.
Oh my God.
In Houston, that he goes to Stanford. He's got it all.